afternoon. I'm Dave Kane, and I have the pleasure of serving as the high school principal at Burlington High School. This has been an odd spring this year with the issues that we've had to deal with during this current pandemic. The Burlington Community School District has had to postpone the traditional commencement ceremony to later on in the summer. Although we have every intention to properly honor the class of 2020 at Bracewell Stadium, the ceremony will not take place until late June or sometime in July. I can't think of a more wonderful venue in which to hold our 2020 commencement ceremony than Bracewell Stadium. Unfortunately, at this point, we will have to settle for this video. Due to the necessity of postponing the ceremony that was to be held today, the district has created a video showcase. We are extremely proud of our graduates and could not allow this day to come and go without putting some sort of celebration together. The staff at Burlington High School are extremely proud of these young people we celebrate today. We extend not only our congratulations to these students, but also to their parents. We have students who are receiving special recognition during the commencement ceremony, symbolized by medals, stoles, and cords they will wear. However, we would like to share those honors with you today. Traditionally, our a cappella choir performs at commencement. Mr. Flaherty and his students have selected a song from one of their concerts that is fitting for our showcase. We have a video of our students singing Roger Emerson's arrangement of High Hopes.
Oh,
is my pleasure to introduce Dean Vikström, the board president, who will address the class of 2020.
This is hardly the greeting I plan to present. In spite of the situation at hand, you've accomplished a great life goal. You must thank those people who supported you the most, your family, and those school system personnel who have pushed you through your education. This generation has learned a hard lesson, that there are factors you cannot control. With this in mind, you must learn to deal with the situation and move in a positive direction. This is a time to determine what is most important and the relationships that are most valuable. Life is a series of choices which are more in the spotlight because of the current events. Good choices will enable you much better alternatives to choose from later. Above all else, accept that we need all of us to create a society which benefits all of us. No one can do this by themselves. Be kind. I leave you with the thought of that great philosopher, Yogi Berra. When you come to a fork in the road, take it. Go Greyhounds.
Thank you, Mr. Vikström. As is the tradition at Burlington High School, we will now hear from both the salutatorian and valedictorian of the class. It is my honor to introduce the salutatorian, Ms. Peyton Davis, daughter of Mr. Mike and Ms. Lori Davis.
Are any of you familiar with the scene from The Office where Dwight has to give a speech and is freaking out the whole time? Well, that's how I feel right now, so with that in mind, I'm going to try and keep this short and sweet for both your sake and mine. First off, on the behalf of the class of 2020, I would like to thank all friends, family, faculty, and guests for joining us in the first ever BHS virtual graduation. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Peyton Davis, and I have a bad habit of using outdated phrases such as, my dogs are barking, or that really chaps my khakis. Go ahead, make fun of me, I'm used to it. Anyways, one phrase that I think about constantly is the saying, it takes a village. Now, usually that phrase is used to reference raising a child and the support system that child and family has. But I think it's a perfect way to think of high school. It takes a huge village or community to get over 200 kids to graduate high school. Within every village, there are law keepers, and for us, that's our administration, and for student council members, it's Tina Link, who we refer to as the Siri of BHS. But in all seriousness, our lawmakers don't get enough credit and have done a great job getting us to the point right now. Except for Mr. Reese when it comes to school dances. Come on, man, we all know cuss words. Let us listen to good music. And a village wouldn't be successful without its hunters, fishermen, gatherers, who are responsible for keeping everyone alive and feeding us. I like to think of these as our teachers. They are constantly feeding us with knowledge, and if you're lucky enough, they'll give you candy too. Our teachers are amazing. They deal with all our sass, listen to our problems, and help prepare us for the real world. I know we all have a favorite teacher, but mine personally was Mr. Krowski. Sorry, Tager, you are a close second. For those of you who don't know, Krowski teaches AP Euro and Government, which, in my opinion, happen to be the two worst classes offered at BHS. While the material he taught was horrible to listen to, he was able to make it fun and engaging, which made the class more engaging. What made Krowski stand out is that he listened to all my nerdy school problems, gave some pretty good life advice, and gave all his students cosmic brownies on their birthday. I know that all of you have a teacher like this, someone who listened, someone who made an impact on your life, and someone who made your overall high school experience better. And a village wouldn't be complete without a crazy person. And for us, it's a toad shoe wearing, moped driving, bald crazy man that goes by the name of Ryan Osborne. While the teachers and admin do everything in their power to make our little village run as smooth as possible, there are always bumps in the road. And for us, it's a pandemic-sized bump. We were deprived of our last trimester, last season of sports, our last band, choir, or orchestra concerts. We didn't get senior driving boats or prom. We didn't even get a normal graduation. We got our diplomas drive-through style. But I guess this is just preparing us for life. Because if I'm being honest, life isn't always fair. A prime example of life being unfair was when we lost a beloved classmate and friend, Jackson Guyton. Jackson was my best friend all of elementary school, and losing him is by far one of the hardest things that I've had to go through. And I know I speak for many others when I say this. If losing him has taught me anything, it is to live life in the moment and never take anything for granted. So, while in the moment, this pandemic may seem like the end of the world, know that it's not, and we will all be okay again soon. But through thick and thin, what keeps our village from falling apart is us, the students. With us, there never seems to be a dull moment. You wake up one morning thinking it's going to be a normal day, and you get to school and see Marshawn jumping through a window. Or you're sitting at a homecoming assembly and see some weird girl in a blindfold run into a wall. And I won't name names, but it definitely wasn't me. Our class has changed the way people view BHS for the better and has the potential to change the world. In the words of a famous philosopher and poet, Kanye West, our work is never over. So congratulations, everyone. We did it.
Thank you, Ms. Payton. I would now like to introduce Ms. Katie Kanon, this year's valedictorian. Katie is the daughter of Mr. Tony and Ms. Nancy Kanon.
Hi, everybody. My name is Katie Kanon, and before I give my speech, I just wanted to give a little note from past Katie. It's 1:17 a.m., and I'm supposed to record this speech in less than 9 hours for virtual graduation. The only problem is, I decided to completely restart my speech. I remember when I found out that I was valedictorian, I looked up on Google valedictorian speech tips. Don't ask me why, it just seemed like a really good place to start. But I can't sleep right now because I feel like I didn't even follow the first step, which was to speak from my heart. So I figured I had nothing to lose, so I wanted to give it another go. I know Peyton talked about the past, so you're all probably super reminiscent and sappy right now. Because I know I am. I guess now it's my job to just talk about the future and be hopeful for you all. But if I'm being honest, I'm just terrified. But after sitting here for a minute, I realized that I had absolutely nothing to be terrified about, and neither should any of you guys. Out of everything I've learned since freshman year, one quote that a teacher told me that really stuck with me was that sometimes it takes a bad grade to learn a good lesson. I remember that I would stay up every single night crying because I was so stressed about my grades. But I'm going to tell you now that even if you didn't take the best grades, that does not mean you're a failure. Being a student myself and growing up with you guys, I'm going to tell you now that from my experience, some of the smartest kids in our class got bad grades. And I am definitely not the smartest person here just because I'm up here. So if you made a couple mistakes, that's okay. Because that's what childhood in school is all about. We're here to learn. But now this is your time to shine. And I'm not saying that grades aren't important, because learning good skills at a young age is definitely important. But if you didn't take good grades, that doesn't define you one bit. And if you don't know what you want to do when you grow up, that doesn't mean you're a failure either. My parents both came here as immigrants, barely speaking any English, and now they have a family, house, stable jobs. Most importantly, they're really happy. Another fear I developed throughout senior year was moving on from all of my memories. I've made a lot of good friends throughout high school, and not just with my peers, but with my teachers. I'm sure you all remember, but I was the gross little kid with one friend growing up, and I would come home thinking, what's wrong with me? But now I look at myself, and I've met so many people who've helped me to grow. But let me tell you that even if you're scared about moving on, this is not the end. We have 60 more years to make amazing memories. And even if our time got cut short, no matter how much time we had, we still wouldn't have felt like it was enough anyways. We can't stop the future from coming, and we can't just stay here in the past. So don't let your fear of change hold you back, because let me tell you that regret is a whole lot worse than change. Trust me on that one. The third fear that went through my head during senior year was on my 18th birthday. I thought, oh no, I'm an adult now. It was terrifying, which I'm sure everyone else was also terrified after seeing the classic 50-year-old dad with an expensive mortgage and heartburn, aka my dad. But honestly, I don't know why we're all so scared about becoming an adult, because there's a lot to do after high school. So I say that we learn from our parents' mistakes, and let's take our new opportunities and live a life that our future kids will look forward to. And most importantly, I always stand by this. Please don't go into a career just for the money. Do what you love and money will come. I remember the last Google tip I found online was to thank the people who made you who you are today. And I want to thank every single person here, because during high school, everyone here taught me so much. I met so many different types of people during these past 4 years, and I learned so much from each of them. You all gave me a glimpse into the real world. And in the real world, what matters most isn't about how much money you have, how successful you are, but it's who you are as a person. No one's gonna go to your funeral and say, wow, she had so much money, or she had such a good job. They're gonna talk about what you were like as a person. And despite what everyone says about BHS in the school newspaper, or in the newspaper, our school is filled with so many amazing and kind people, and I am so proud to say that I grew up here. So thank you for a wonderful 4 years. And a little quote, as Cahil Gibran said, and let today embrace the past with remembrance and the future with longing. Thank you.
It is now with great pleasure that I introduce Mr. Pat Cohen, Superintendent of Burlington Community Schools, who will address the class.
First and foremost, congratulations. You are Burlington Community School District's newest alumni. As you move forward in life, some of your Greyhound experiences may begin to fade, while other Greyhound memories will remain vivid. Additional experiences may lay dormant until awoken when you see an old friend and they say, "Remember when?" Each of you has your own remember when. Some will make you smile, some laugh, and some may even make you cry. I encourage you to stay connected with your classmates and to remember your memories are important. But more importantly, I encourage you to move forward, utilizing your Burlington education to propel yourself to future successes and accomplishments. Go Greyhounds! In so many ways, I sincerely regret the disruptive and destructive chaos COVID-19 has brought globally, as well as to our little corner of the world here in Burlington, Iowa. We learn in life that often we have little to no control over circumstances that greatly impact us as individuals, as members of a group, or as a collective citizenry, as COVID-19 has on a global perspective. COVID has spawned seemingly countless difficulties and appears endless. This is also a fact. You, the class of 2020, can go one of two ways. You can allow these difficulties and misfortune to negatively affect you, or you can show resilience, rise above the challenge, show mental, moral, and physical strength. The very strengths found throughout time, whenever and wherever humanity has found themselves challenged by seemingly overwhelming adversity. I have no doubt, none, that you, the class of 2020, will distinguish yourself by displaying the very mental, moral, and physical strengths that have constantly advanced and distinguished mankind throughout all of history. You got this, class of 2020. Hey, class of 2020, in closing, I'll pass on a little wisdom to you. Life's sometimes hard enough. You don't need to make it any harder on yourself. All you have to do, you will be a better person, a better student, a better employee. Shoot, you'll even be a better spouse and a better parent if you always are on time, be hardworking, and be respectful. You don't do these things, and life's going to be tough. You do, and you're going to flourish. Again, be on time, be respectful, be hardworking. And when you aren't, recognize it, apologize to those that you hurt, and strive to not do it again. Be on time, be hardworking, and be respectful. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish each and every one of you the best, and I am proud of you individually and collectively. I'm telling you what, you have a good, strong work ethic and this solid Burlington education. You're going to do great in life. Now get out there and flourish by being on time, being respectful, and being hardworking. Thank you.
Now it's time to recognize our graduates. To do so, we allowed each student to create one formal slide, and if they chose to do so, a second slide that represents some of the experiences while attending Burlington High School. bring the showcase to a close, I want to thank those who are responsible for making this possible. It will begin with our guidance counselors, Tamara Levinson, Angie Leinbach, Sarah Mum, our social worker, Lori Bray, and our office staff, Juanita Phipps, Brittany Keeley, Amy Sterler, and Sherelle Coleman. Also, a special thank you to our senior class sponsor, Annette Mossback, who has dedicated her time and her efforts to our seniors year after year. I would be remiss not to acknowledge and thank the teachers across the district for all the work they have done, not only to educate the young people here before us, but also all they have done to guide them in becoming fine young men and women. Without the foundations established at the elementary and middle schools, they would not have experienced the kind of success they had at Burlington High School. I'd also like to thank Mr. Murphy and Mr. Flaherty for providing the music for the presentation. And lastly, I'd like to extend a thank you to the rest of the high school administrative team, Jenna Krieger-Cohen, Vita Long, David Reese, Jay Huff, and Zach Shea. As our tradition, I will now invite all Greyhounds to join in Go Get 'em Greyhounds. Into your future, I would also encourage you to never forget where you came from. Always remember, once a Greyhound, always a Greyhound.